Look at this. Nothing better than a wide open track on a 75 degree afternoon. Santa Barbara, towards the end of January, it's absolutely gorgeous. This is Santa Barbara City College track, which is right across from the beach. Can't really see it, but one of the best places in the world to work out. Along with my outdoor gym up at my buddy's place, which is actually just right up over the hills over there. It's like 2 minutes up the street. Pretty insane place to work out. Anyway, I'm gonna do some hurdles today, maybe do some jumping. I think my friend's gonna join me and have some fun. I'll catch up with you guys in a minute. Woo, just got done warming up. Did some jog, a couple laps, did some stretching, some form running, and then did a couple laps of walk the curve, stride the straights. My boys bailed on me today, Geoff and Tristan. You sons of, they can't hang with me. The only one that showed up was little old Christina. Where is she? There she is. So we're gonna do some hurdles, maybe some jumping. We pulled the pits off the jumping mat there. So gonna have some fun with it, see how it goes. I might even do some intervals afterwards, but I'll try to film for you guys and show you what we're doing. So I'll catch you in a little. These are great. You don't even have to be a hurdler to benefit from these. Like, just from all the squatting and like heavy leg lifting I do, doing step overs and stuff like this, really starts to kind of loosen my muscles up a little bit, make sure I can keep that flexibility. Hits a little bit of different areas, like your hip flexors that you don't normally hit that much. My hip flexors have been really tight when I've been squatting, so getting out here and doing some hurdle drills and stuff like that, I think is gonna really help me, and it's fun too. So if you're a hurdler and you're watching this video, some really cool things that you can work on this drill. When you step it over, make sure you're driving up from your hip flexor. And when you're putting your leg down, you drive your trail leg and you just whip the shit out of it all the way over to the next hurdle. So I'm not actually stepping down here, I'm going all the way over to the next hurdle. And it's really important, and I'll show you this way, that you get that trail leg up all the way in, like as high as you basically can up here. Because I see a lot of people that straight leg hurdles, which means they go over them like this. And then they just let their trail leg hang way back here like this. This is what we call hip opening up. We never want that when you hurdle. You always want to stay square to the hurdle. And the only way you can do that is if you bring your trail leg like that. Like, a lot of people have a tendency when they hurdle, they just let this leg hang way behind them like that. That's not what you want to do. You want to be bringing it up like that. And you have to have the strength and flexibility in order to do that. And that's what this drill will help you with. So that when you're coming like this, ripping that trail leg over with all like a ton of power. So give that a shot next time. I'm sure everyone that's hurdled has done these drills, but if you think about the right things when you do them, it'll make all the difference. Let's watch Christina. Oh yeah. Oh, that last one was perfect. Here, you wanna show us that again?
No.
So another one of my favorite drills for hurdles, and you can do this for high hurdlers or 400 hurdlers, is a drill I call a quick step drill. We used to do this at Penn State. You wanna basically set up between four or five hurdles, and then you put it 4 foot lengths, about 4.5 actually. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and then give it a little half. So that's actually perfect. I just eyeballed that one. And you set them up, 4 of them like that. And then I'll show you what we're gonna do in a second after I set them up. Okay. So now we have them set up. I just did 4 for today, so I'm gonna show them what it looks like. So that's what it looks like. Again, this drill is called quick step drill. It's kind of an advanced drill, but I just throw people into it, my athletes, and I'm just like, you know, give it a shot. What you do is you do just lead leg, just trail leg, and then you go over the top. And what it forces you to do, a lot of kids in high school, myself included, when I started learning how to hurdle, I straight leg hurdle, and when you straight leg hurdle, it causes a whole host of problems. We won't go into that right now. But what this forces you to do, since they're so close, is it forces you to keep your levers bent. So, you know, you're stepping over your lead like this, and you bring in your trail nice and close and tight to your body, and it forces you to do it. And so, it's, and they just come up so quick that if you
straighten your leg at all, you're gonna hit the hurdles, and your body knows that, so it'll make adjustments and it forces you to do it. So maybe I'll do a couple, I'll have Stina show you a couple so you can see what it looks like. If you're scared about going over the hurdle at first, you can just kind of go off to the side like she did there. What? You can just kind of go off to the side like she did there. When you're first learning, you don't have to go over the hurdle because it can be a little bit intimidating. Just some string of incomplete. Never to lead me to anything remotely close to my Another thing with this drill, along with coming up with bent levers, the other thing you really want to do is you want to drive down very close to the hurdle on the opposite side. And that's something you'll see if you ever watch the world-class hurdlers. When they come over the hurdle, they're stepping really close off that hurdle. Because when you're getting into three-stepping in the short hurdles, when you're actually at that level, you get too close to the hurdles. So you actually need every last bit of room that you can. Also, your trail leg can't do anything until your lead leg is done. So the faster you drive that lead leg back down, the quicker your trail leg's gonna snap over and the faster you're gonna be. Okay. All right, so I'm gonna show you guys trail leg now. This one people have a lot of difficulty with because you're still using your lead leg, like you're going over a hurdle, but there's not actually anything over here. And so you just have to kind of imagine like the hurdle just keeps going across, you know? Because if you don't use your trail leg, you get into like a really weird like pissing on a hydrant action. And the other thing that I always tell people is always be leaning forward, because when you're leaning forward after you're in the air, you'll kind of come back anyway and you'll land in a running position. So that's another thing, always attacking, diving almost into the hurdle. So I'll show you what trail leg looks like. This one's a little sketchy. You have to have the flexibility or else you literally can't do it, and you'll be forced to open up your hips if you don't have the flexibility. So that's why drills like this and drills like the step overs that we were showing you, it's teaching your body that, well, it's basically forcing your body to have that flexibility and the strength too in your hip flexors. So let's watch Christina go. Yeah, come on. On that sunny day, didn't know I'd meet such a beautiful girl walking down the street, seen those bright brown eyes. So after we've done a couple on our lead leg, a couple on our trail leg, and sometimes, especially with my 400 hurdlers, I'll have them do their alternate leg too, which can get really scary on this drill, so be careful with that. Then we go over the top, which is also an amazing Sylvester Stallone movie. If you haven't seen it, you should watch that shit. And over the top, you have to be really careful that you don't get too much speed going into the hurdles or else you're gonna bust your ass, and I've seen it happen a lot. So be careful with this one. I'll try to demonstrate, we'll see how it looks. Dust the cobwebs off. I'll catch you in a second. Carry on this way, this thing might leave the ground. How would you like to fly? The summer queen should ride. But you still deserve the crown. Hasn't it been found? Mama, listen. There you go. There's a couple hurdle drills you can try out with your athletes. Sideways step overs, forward step overs, and quick step drill. Give it a shot. It should help keep your hurdlers from straight legging, make them get a little quicker over the hurdle, and help increase their flexibility and their hip flexor power, basically. So give it a shot. Catch you guys soon.